your children now. The saints, you have a 3-day bath. Bath night and day. I went on a bath 2 weeks ago because we have mold in our house. And I don't know whether it's affecting me or what, but I went to the doctor and he said, the other week, and he said, Miss Boo, he said, I can't see. No. He said, all I know, it must be some kind of allergy. But he said, I'm going to give you some. He gave me 4 types of medicine, pills I was supposed to take. A whole lot of them one day, but then go less and less and less. And I still don't feel too much better. I thought it was for me not drinking water. But y'all just continue to pray for me. Because I know the Lord is a healer, because he has healed me so many times. Now we just get back to the children. The children really need prayer. Just get out and pray. Do you pray for your children? Tell them to come and kneel with you sometime. Or you go and say the night prayer. And at least to say, Lord, lay me down to sleep, pray for my soul. If I die before I wake, pray for my soul to take. That thing is crazy. But let me tell you something. Praying from your heart. Let's pray, church. Because all I can see, when a policeman walk up to some young black boy and shoot their brain out, we need to pray. And protect them from happiness. Because my grandson, Bob, was walking along the Philadelphia street. And all of a sudden, he said, they jumped out on him. And he said, they had guns drawn on him. And he said, his heart began to. And he said, ask him, where is he coming? He said, I'm just coming from the store. I came from work late, and I had to go to the store and get me something to eat. And he almost thought that they was going to shoot him. And it gave him a hard condition. And his doctor said, you know, man, they can do that to you. They can draw their guns out. But somebody can draw their guns out on him, them, because they're going to reap what they sow. And let's pray. I can't really. You know, if we need to pray, we forgot about God all together. We packed our suitcase for help and told God goodbye. In your church, all the churches that you go. People don't fast no more. They don't pray. They don't read the scripture. Every day, I try to read the scripture in the name of one verse. And every morning that I wake up, I say, thank God. Because I know I'm living on God's time. Thank God for another day. Yeah. And I wonder, I said, if I never say mother, where would I be today? Amen. Where would I be? Mother, you play a very important part, especially the aged mothers in church. And that's what makes you single mother experience. Experience in the church. You can't, you know, you don't, you have to do what you say. You have to know what you say and do what you say. And I thank God, you know, let's live the life. Put our children on the altar.
Yes,
yes. Amen. You know, Pop Kelly. We used to call him Pop Kelly because he was a good influence for the young men and women in our church at being a father. Yes. A whole lot of them didn't have a father. One time, he used to go to the beach every day. And one day, we missed one of the young men in church. We saw the lifeguards, and they had these big, great big rakes scraping the ocean bottom. But that's where our pastor lived, on the ocean. And they scraped the ocean bottom. And sometimes they'd bring up tide on this. And every now and then, you'd see them bringing up a body. And one of the young men that was on our church, well, they brought him up. You know, and it just broke our hearts to be obedient. The Bible said, train up a child the way it should go. Sometimes you don't train them enough. School, we taught that. Get them before six. At six, and after six is too late. But I'm gonna tell you, bursting is too late. You get them when you're in, you try to teach them when you're in their mother's womb. Because we had some nurses working, they were working in the church. And they said, Mother Blue, I want you to go to Kings County Hospital, pediatrics ward. And you should see those babies the way they are born ready. Drug addicts, alcoholics, because their mother drinking liquor like they, and using drugs, and just messing up those young babies. So we got to start training babies when they're in our womb. I'm just telling you.